We are back on American in Yerevan, talking about fashion sense and all things fashion, and I'm pretty sure that we have figured out a technical difficulty with the phone, and we are here talking to you, Lisa.
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, how are you? Well, thank you for your patience.
You're welcome, you're welcome.
And thank you for calling your first caller ever. Congratulations.
And I think that I should have some surprise or some prize for that.
Oh, yes, I'm going to think about that.
I'll mention it later.
Okay.
Yep, of course, I'm ready. Yes, I have some examples, but now I'll speak about one thing that I like most. For example, in 50s or in 60s, women used to wear high-waisted skirts and pants, and you know that then it changed to low-rise. But I'm very happy that recently we have back 16th fashion, because it's very comfortable to wear the waisted top. Because it was very uncomfortable for me to wear low-rise skirts or pants. And now I'm very happy for that case.
And I have something that, for my own comfort too, when I was a kid, my uncle had this jacket. It was called a members only jacket. Have you heard of this jacket?
Yeah.
Members only is like this really cool leather jacket with the elastic around the waist and around the wrist.
I remember it.
And when I was a kid, it was already totally uncool. But my uncle had saved the jacket, and then my grandma saved the jacket. And I thought, well, why did I get the jacket? Maybe it'll be cool someday.
Maybe, you know, maybe it's very nice someday.
But I already will. I wear it all the time.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it's so cool, but it's comfortable.
That's good. The fashion is all the time it's back.
Yeah, it's all the time coming back in the cycles of things. But the thing that I think isn't really coming back is the mullet. For some reason, it's still around, but it's not so cool. Do you know what a mullet is? It's when there's business up front and party in the back with really short up front and you're in the back. Yeah, it's a hairdo.
Yeah. I think that's in 5 or 10 years it will be back as well.
Oh, gosh.
Okay.
Well, Mimi, thank you so much for your call today.
Okay, it was nice to talk to you.
Nice to talk to you too. Call back sometime soon.
Have a nice evening. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Have you seen any examples of this moment? No. We had the new kids on the block at the same time. Okay, to settle this, we need to play the song, Daily Erosion, and then we're going to play another song by Stick around, you're listening to 103.0 with you alone. Even though it was a few songs ago, and both of them were remixes of covers, I still have to say that each of them was I question. Well, let me ask you, as a former woman, teenage girl, and a woman now, something about makeup. What can you tell me about people and their makeup? Because, you know, I do wear makeup. I'm an actor, so in the theater or for filming, I have to wear makeup, right? But I don't wear makeup in life, and I don't really understand the rules to wearing makeup, and maybe the differences between the cultures. Sure, yeah. Every day when you're working, but they're still wearing all of the makeup that they would wear for like a cocktail party or something. Don't wear makeup, you're not wearing makeup. Thank you enough for your very useful advice. I don't really need advice. But make it up to you. I will play the first one. Bend your eyes. Where fashion is coming from these days, it seems like a lot of it is from music videos and TV and film and pop culture, really, because it seems that people really are interested in, for example, what Katy Perry had for breakfast, or what kind of haircut Kim Kardashian's dog got this week, right? And these people, they seem to be posting all of these things on their social media, so on Facebook, on Twitter, Instagram, and so I, as a person who wants to become more like Katy Perry, hypothetically, if I wanted to become more like Katy Perry, I would post things about what I have to do, what kind of haircut my dog has. You can post all of these things all day, every day on my Twitter and my Instagram and my Facebook. And it's funny because, yeah, it's like almost like we're trying to create connections to people, but we're creating those connections with people who are really far away and missing maybe the people that are sitting in front of us. Right? Yeah. There's a paradox and I'm hesitant to say so, but I did post this video on our Facebook page, American Indian One, on Facebook. You can go and you can look and watch this really great social app. It's a social app that Coca-Cola made, and I think it's in the past year, about their solution to the social media problem. It's called the Safeguard. In order to spend time with the people that you're with, I won't spoil it for you, but yeah, if you have a couple of minutes with your time, go and check it out. Right now, it is 10:58. And we have only 2 minutes left in our program. Unfortunately, we are off until. Yeah, we can move in and come in. We will be back next Wednesday at 9 p.m. Stick around, we'll be back Wednesday.